Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. A warm welcome to one and all for the fifth session of the Super 25 program, India's largest online stock traders conference. It's my great pleasure today to welcome Mr. Piyush Chaudhary, the founder of Wave Analytics, as a speaker in our program. His topic of interest is trading the trend. A quick introduction, he is a founder of Wave Analytics. He's one of the senior most experts in Elliott Wave in the country. He is a classical pattern expert. He does trading systems and also candlesticks. And he believes in scientific forms of analysis with predefined parameters, which generally give higher payoffs through very consistent accuracy rates. With this as an introduction, I would like to hand over the line to Piyush. Piyush, the stage is yours. Thank you very much for being with us.
Thank you so much, Ashok. Good evening, everyone. And my name is Piyush Chaudhary. So today, what we are going to discuss is basically trading the trend. Now, a lot of times, what happens in the stock market is that everyone is usually looking for the U-turn. Everyone is always betting on the U-turn, that the market will take the U-turn and let me bet. Let me take a long because market is going to bounce. Let me take a short because market is going to crack. But whatever happens, in most of the times, a lot of money is not made while the market is trending. Nifty goes from, say, 7,000 to 11,000 one shot, and people would be just viewing the market, will not be entering for the fear that they don't want to ride the trend. Most traders make this mistake of trying to always do the counter trade, counter trend trade, while the trend is still strong. So when we are talking about whether the market is in a trend or whether to go for the counter trend trade, whether to stick to the trend, where is the evaluation? How do we really evaluate what to really do? Today we are going to evaluate how to check the trend and whether to participate in the trend or to go counter. Now, to go counter would be another thing altogether, but at least whether to participate in the trend or not. Let's begin. This is our thank you for the sponsor. I basically started my a little bit of introduction. I did my MBA in finance in 2001. I also did my ICWA. I'm from a complete commerce background, BCom honors and everything. So since 2003, I've been into stock market. From 2003 to 2008, I was working with brokers, K.R. Choksi, Motilal Oswal, MF Global. And from 2008, I have been an independent trader. In 2013-14, I started with my firm. And at that time, it was still discretionary trading. But sometime in 2017, we started with the algorithms. And since then, primarily have been sticking to algorithms. 90-95% of my own trades annually are done via algorithms. Discretionary part is there, but it's very minimal now. Though obviously a little bit of discretionary cannot go out of hand. So we began the trading the trend. I'll be mostly jumping from the slide to this terminal, the way I analyze. So this is less of a presentation and more of a workshop, you can say. So you'll also, you might have to make some notes, you might have to take some screenshots. So all those things you'll have to do. And so I'll teach you some techniques first. So whenever we look at trends, first of all is the simple visual understanding of trends. What is a trend? A trend is when, now you look at this, now the recent example. Let's focus here, this zone. Let's focus this zone. What was happening in this zone? Market was one candle to another. They were having outside days. Now, what are outside days? When the candle range is not intersecting with each other much. It did intersect here, but then again there were gaps and it was running away. Here again it kept running away. What happens in a trending market is that market is always having outside days where the trend is, where the intersection is not much. The bodies of the candles are large, the wicks are smaller, which indicate that the market is clearly going in a single unidirection. It is intending to go in a particular direction. So at that point of time, obviously there's, you get a hunch. Now, contrary to this kind of a move, look at this move. The market is entirely patchy. It is, the candles are intersecting with each other. The ranges are intersecting with each other. There is no clear flow. One day there's a white candle, another day there's a black candle. Is there a flow? There's no real flow. The bodies are small and wicks are large, wicks are there visible. So they're not really moving ahead. It is going up, but is this market on the left, can be equated the same on the right? Not really, because you can visually see that. But can we mathematically define that? Yes, we can mathematically define that. So to see that, there's a simple tool. In fact, there's a statistical tool of regression trend channels. Now, what a regression trend channel does is that it basically does the correlation of data. Now, suppose you were taking a close value of all these bars and putting it in the Excel file, run the correlation, you would get what the regression trend channels Pearson's R gives. So let's see, if you are running a trend, you start from this highest point, and suppose you were sitting here, could you have guessed there was a trend in place? Just understand how to plot it first. Here I have taken inputs as deviation of +3 and -3. Now, if you remember a simple mathematical concept that mean plus minus one standard deviation covers nearly 67% of the data. Mean plus minus two standard deviations cover nearly 95% of the data. And mean plus minus three standard deviations covers nearly 99% of the data. Here, source I have taken not as close. I always like the HLC by 3, which is the typical price. I use this because it helps in understanding the termination of trend much faster than close value. So even if the close value was different from higher than or lower than the previous bars, HLC by 3 actually tells us if the trend was really ending or not. So by experience, I've been using regression trend channels since almost 8-10 years now into my trading, and close values are a laggard to use with the regression trend channels. HLC by 3 are far more credible, stable, and a little more on the proactive part. They will tell you one or two bars before the close values when the trend is ending. So while in the beginning of the trend, it may not help you much, but when you are spotting the end of trend, it helps you a lot. So always use the HLC by 3. Now here I have made basically two templates of my regression trend channel since I use them a lot. One is WA3, which is +3, -3 standard deviation of the same HLC by 3 as the close values, with obviously lighter colors. And the Pearson's R is the Pearson's R coefficient, is the coefficient of correlation. It tells you how strongly the data is correlated. And so the higher the values, it oscillates between 0 to 1, this value of Pearson's R. And higher the value, it means the data is strongly correlated, which means so a value of 0.90 or above 0.90 means that the trend is strongly in place. So that is where the correlation is. So here we are seeing, now here we have plotted only till this bar, from this bar to this bar, the trend was already in place In essence, R had already crossed 0.90. The trend was already visible. Whether people realized it or not, whether they were in denial or not, that is secondary. The trend was in place. So at that point of time, we look here, definition of a trend. Outside days, yes. Large bodies of candles was happening. Actually, in this case, they were lesser than large gaps. Instead of large bodies of candles, it was also gaps. So gaps were playing the roles of those large bodies of candles. Back in a few years ago, why there you will feel there were lesser gaps in the markets was because there was no pre-open in the market at that point of time. So the market used to open. So Nifty used to open exactly where it closed. And from there, in a fraction of seconds, it used to move wherever it was supposed to move. But the pre-open market has changed the game a little and has started, an index has started happening, and index has started witnessing gaps. The spot index has started witnessing gaps. Earlier, the spot never used to witness gaps. So the data today cannot be entirely compared to the data 7-8 years ago when there was no pre-open. So the large bodies of candles can also include the gaps part. The wicks are smaller. The regression trend channel in the arithmetic scale. Now that is a very important part. If you plot regression trend channel on a log scale, it goes haywire because the standard deviation and everything, the scale goes haywire. So regression trend channels, whenever you are plotting, plotted in the arithmetic linear scale, not on the log scale. Okay, so now we come back here. Now what are we going to do here is that first of all, we define this, whether the trend is established or not, then how to get into the trend. The first part we have done, I'll give you one example first, and then we'll go into the literature of it. Then you can make notes in the right now, just understand what we are doing. So what we have done right now, I hope it's all clear. The screen, the numbers, everything is clear. Even if they are small, please zoom in. It should be above 0.90. Anything below 0.90, reject it. That is not the trend, which we will also see by many examples. So I'll take the first example in a very exhaustive way so that the second and the third examples become very additive and they help you understand the concept. They only help you finalize on the concept, the furnishing of the concept. Here, now we'll go back from the beginning. Let's suppose we are tracking this market. We are here. We saw Nifty till here. Till the day is closed, we still want to see whether the Nifty has started catching the trend. Another thing that you'll have to understand is that anything under 10 bars, the trend verification may not be very strong. Anything, so some 8, 10 bars or maybe 15 bars are absolutely okay for the trend to get in motion. Don't start looking at a trend from the first 3, 4, 5 bars. But sometimes, in a very rare scenario, if you have strong 3 white soldiers, long ranged, and 3 black crows, they can be the definition of a trend. They really can begin the trend very big time. So unless that is happening, a trend takes usually 8 to 10 bars to establish itself. The only exception being 3 white soldiers and 3 black crows. Here we do not have that. So I'm taking live examples. Now suppose you were standing here on 27th Feb. You want to see if the market has and you had already broken this low, and the market has already broken this low. You want to see if the market is really going in a particular trend or not. Check it here. The market had started catching the trend. It had already crossed 0.90, and this thing, the Nifty was already in a movement of trend. So what do you do at this point of time? You can't do anything because our strategy says that when we spot a trend, as a step two, we wait. Now here we are plotting another plus and minus 2 standard deviation.